Hello, everyone. Welcome to Extra Time. Steve Nicol, the first question is for you.
Ooh, that was quick.
Why are you not verified on Twitter?
No idea.
Do you know what verified means?
I think so. I'm not bothered.
It is the blue tick of wonder.
But what's the difference?
It's so that people know that it's the real Steve Nicol and not someone pretending to be Steve Nicol.
Well, I really don't care. Oh. If you don't believe it, then that's...
Are you sure you are you?
Are you you?
Are you you?
Can I get back to you or not?
Well, you're verified, you can.
Do you have a blue... Oh, can we talk about what's going on at the moment with you, or do you prefer to keep that private?
By the way,
Shaka.
I don't know. Is anything in my life private?
Shaka's off Twitter.
He's done.
Were you verified?
Yes.
So how did you do it anyway?
Someone at work, someone here.
Somebody came in. Somebody from Twitter came in and got everybody done in a batch.
I see, I can't even bother with that nonsense. If you just had to go like that, then I would probably do
it. Yeah, but
it.
I think if you could just do that, then everyone would have a blue tick. There has to be some sort of discrepancy.
Oh, well, that's fine. I'm not bothered.
I could just have a picture of you going, I'm Steve Nicol.
Somebody did that with me. Somebody did. Their Twitter handle was Hislop Shaka.
Oh.
And just pulled a photo of mine from a Twitter handle.
Right.
They were just abusing people on Twitter.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Mm. I had to let my bosses know, listen, that's not me.
Wow.
And then they just kind of ran out of steam. And...
Yeah, but your name's Shaka Hislop. Not Hislop Shaka. Mm-hmm. That would give it away straight away.
Sid got a blue tick.
Straight away.
Do you have a blue tick, Sid?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
He's got probably more followers.
I didn't do anything. One day they just contacted me and said, do you want a blue tick? And I said, okay.
Oh, look at you, fancy boy.
Wow, big time, eh?
Big Bertie.
Fancy boy.
Obviously.
Bertie, big spud.
But the thing is, though, of course, I'm not really the kind of person that anyone's going to try and be. I mean, you can imagine that millions of fans out there trying to be Hislop Shaka or Nicol Steve, but no one's going to want to be Low Sid, are they? It's just not going to happen.
How low will they go? Is Maldini the greatest defender ever, Stevie?
Ooh, tell you what, he's up there.
Who is up there?
Ramos.
See, the problem
Ramos.
I'll start throwing names out.
I'm glad you said it and I didn't have to.
Like who? Throw a couple of names out.
Like the Italian Sierra. I mean, he was fantastic. But you never noticed him in a game because he read everything, he killed danger before it even started. I mean, just a proper player. People like Franz Beckenbauer, same thing. You know, he strolled around because he was smart. Bobby Moore, people like that. Alan Hansen, that I played with.
Was he the best defender that you played with?
Yeah, I would say so. And again, for the same reasons, you know, all these guys, I mean, Baresi never really had much to do ever because he either organised that somebody else was in a good position to deal with it, or he did it himself. And when I say deal with it, I mean just by picking out a good position, he stopped the opposition from playing a ball into the position he... I mean, really simple things. You're sitting there smiling, right? Because you've no idea what I'm talking about.
I do know what you're talking about.
I'm appreciating what you're saying. Never mind him.
And I've said it 100 times, I'll say it again. Defending is not about last gasp tackles and sliding in and all that nonsense. That's not what it's about. Doing that, then you've actually been in the wrong place to start. There you go.
Well said, Stephen.
Thank you very much, yeah.
I'm going to
thank you very much,
Hislop
Shaka.
Again when I get home.
Can I call you Hislop Shaka?
You call me whatever you like.
Okay, but thank you, Mr. Hislop Shaka.
That was a beautiful moment, Stephen.
Thank you. You snigger. Hey, Sid, I'll tell you what, he's a wee snigger on the fly.
You say as Sid sniggers.
Well, he does. He waits till the camera's gone and he looks at you with a snigger.
Well, this isn't a snigger. This is a proper laugh. Yeah.
With this lack of playing time, Sid, do you think that Malcolm regrets his decision to join FC Barcelona and could he possibly seek a loan move in winter transfer window?
I think he probably regrets how it's gone so far, but I don't think he'll regret the decision necessarily. I think he would have anticipated playing relatively little, probably not quite as little as he's played so far. He was told in the summer that he would get opportunities, maybe, obviously not to start, but he's maybe had fewer than he would have hoped for. But I don't think he necessarily regrets it. I think I think any player who's in a position where a club like Barcelona comes for them when they're not expecting it. Because remember, this is the key point here. You know, this is a club much bigger than they were anticipating, which is why he was on the verge of going to Italy, which is why fans were waiting for him at the airport in Rome. But this comes along, you can't say no. And I guess the other thing is that, you know, if it really does go wrong, well, then maybe next summer he has similar sorts of options and can move on, and he's only lost 1 year. I think there's still time for him to play a bit of a part this season, but I don't think at any point he's going to be a regular starter.
Meanwhile, Shaq, I haven't heard this story. What do you guys think about Leon Bailey's refusal to play Jamaica unless his brother is also included in the squad?
It's an odd one. It was a falling out between Leon Bailey, his agent, and the Jamaican Football Federation that they just can't come to terms with. And just judging from my own experience, given my standoff with the Trinidad yes. Football Federation, I know that there's a lot more happening behind the scenes than hissy headlines. So I'm not privy to some of those things, but I'm not passing judgment on what we've known so far.
Finally, Shaka, how hard is it to suppress your Trini accent since last night it slipped unintentionally?
Last night? Where was I last night?
I don't know.
Hey, can we not get, hey. Get one of Heslop Shaka's mates to call him up on the phone? Do you know any of them?
Well,
because when he's on the phone, I can't understand a word.
When you're on your phone to assume people from Trini, you go completely Trini.
I know, because when I speak with my Trinidadian accent full on, nobody can understand me. So I left Trinidad a long time ago, over 30 years ago, and I've just kind of, over that time, learned to slow things down, enunciate better when I'm speaking to non-Trinidad and Tobagonians.
Do you still have to make an effort to do that? Or is it all subconscious?
No, it's subconscious. Slowing down is subconscious, no. As is when I speak faster when I'm in Trinidad, let's say.
My kids speak American until they walk through the front door.
Right.
Mm. And they have no idea they're doing it. So it's all these things are definitely subconscious. You know, when they walk in our house, they start talking Scottish. But as soon as they walk out the house and they're in amongst their friends and going about their normal day, they speak with an American.
Mm. How's your American accent?
Oh, it's coming on great.
Yeah?
I'm getting there, aye.
When you
my good friend.
There it is.
Hey there. Howdy. Howdy, Daniel.
Why are they from Texas?
Well, because I've been listening to tapes from Texas.
I've
been listening to American tapes in the car so I can talk American. How's that? Y'all.
Rosetta Stone.
Rosetta Stone from Texas. It was only CD left in the shop.
I thought it was a tape.
Yeah, you're showing your age, no tape. We've moved on for that kind of stuff now, Dan. We use CDs.
Do we?
Yeah.
That's it. anything you'd like to add, Sid, before we go?
Sid, how's
Not
your
really.
Sid, how's your Spanish accent?
Oh. A little bit weird, because it's a mixture of lots of different things. It doesn't make a lot of sense, but yeah, it's there. Although it does change, I must admit, it's a bit like Shaq saying, without meaning to, I was in Montevideo in Uruguay just before the last World Cup.
It, yeah.
And within a day, I was speaking Uruguayan Spanish, and not deliberately, it just kind of happens.
Oh, just that's it. When you're such a culture vulture, it just happens.
Yeah. How's your Cornwall Spanish?
My Spanish is very good, isn't it?
Like,
Dan's Spanish is second to none.
Yeah.
The particular nun in question, I don't know who she is, but it's second to none.
Who speaks better Spanish, Sid? Your six-year-old or you?
Oh, he does, definitely.
Oh, does that annoy you a bit?
He speaks better English as well, though. He speaks much better English.
Writes better articles. And that's it, we're done. That's enough of this. We're back to... There's a lot of games tomorrow. No, there isn't. But there's a lot of games...
I'm coming back tomorrow.
As if he's interested.
No, there is. Milan Derby, Barca Sevilla.
I'm coming tomorrow.
Chelsea United.
I'm in tomorrow as well.
Right. I'll see you tomorrow.
There we go. Bianna, put the graphic on. Come on, let's do this. There it is. We're back tomorrow then to look ahead to those games and sure, much more as well.
Oh, I'll wait.
Frankfurt Dusseldorf.
Oh, yeah.
Howdy, y'all.
Y'all.
Yeah.
Oh. Sham.
Oh,
hey y'all. Hey y'all.
Ah.